workshop on eliminate your stress in bed for a hour or so. So let us say this workshop. Our consciousness is having 7 layers. Can you tell me what are the 7 layers? First is the gross level, the body. And after that, the breath, mind, fourth one, intellect, fifth one, memory, sixth one, ego, seventh one, ourself. So, these 7 levels of our consciousness, as we are aware of this one, then our life will become easier. Now, we have, and also in these 7 layers, we will grossest one is the body, subtlest one is the self. So, this gross to the subtle, the journey, the awareness will increase through different things. Now, what is this? What is health mean? This is what said by His Holiness Shri Dhanchanka. Body without disease, breath without fever, mind without stress, intellect without conflict, memory without confusion, ego which will answer all the time, self without sorrow. This is what is called as health. So do we have that? We will have that one if you attend to all these 7 layers of things. And after doing yoga, you felt very energetic. Yeah? So, where did we get the energy from? Where do we get? A. Okay? Energy, where from do we get?
Oxygen.
Oxygen, A, very good.
Solar plex.
Fire. Okay, that means heat. Okay. Vitamin D, heat, yeah.
Space,
area, then more.
Food.
Food and heat are sun, light, all this one is one category. Oxygen, A, this is one category. So there are actually we categorized into four. So two categories are over. Two more categories are over. Where from we are getting energy. See the prana. Prana is setting life force energy. So where we are getting the prana to function? So one is air, one is food. Sunlight, food, water, these are all becoming one category. So two more are there. I give it up. If you don't rest well, what will happen? Will feel
tired.
So that means rest or sleep will give you also energy. Agree with me?
Yes.
And one more is that. So you have good food, you have good sleep, you have then you are breathing nicely. But sometimes you feel sleepy. It will much energy. So what will you? How will you get that energy? One more source is left. It is happiness, happy mind, or calm mind, peaceful, peace, or the knowledge. All these are into one category. So what are they? Let us revise. First one, sleep. Let us go like this. Feel sleep or rest. Second one. Happy mind or calm mind, okay?
Food.
Then fourth one is? The first one you said, breath. So now, let us balance our tamas and rajas and increase the sattva. Actually, what is meant by this? This is the categories of the food. Sattvic food, tamasic food and rajasic food. So what is, so you can go through this one fast. What is the tamasic food? It will give you sleep, sleepiness, procrastination. You know, you cannot prioritize what is great, what is the first your choice, what is the best thing. You can't prioritize. So there is a procrastination, loss of interest. All this will be given by the tamasic food. And the rajasic food will give you, okay, where is the tamasic food? Tamasic food will be onion, garlic, fatty food, and the more stale food, and the kids, which are stored for a long time, green food, then, so these are all having the tamas. And then, rajasic food, what is rajasic? It gives you activity, restlessness. If you increase too much, it will give you restlessness. People are using constantly move here and there, and they shake their hands, all this. This is restlessness in the system. And then, too many thoughts also you will get when you rajas is too much in the system. But for the activity, you require rajas. And you have to get impatient also. You can't stay. Something like 3:30, something supposed to be started, and you are there by 3:30, and it is not started. It is getting late, but still you feel impatient. You are very calm. But that will happen only when the rajas is the human system is channelized properly. So where are the rajasic foods? Can you guess? What are the rajasic foods? Where the rajas is there more? Rich food. See, raja honga khan. So which is like sugar, mithai, then all the spicy. And oil, a lot of oil and which is made. These are all our rajma, protein, high protein. These are all these rajasic food. And but you have to take that one and you have to do accordingly the activity also. Yeah, then the system, then your whole system will be balanced. Then what about sattva? Sattva means sattva living in joy and lightness, purity, beauty, and it will give. When you are with a lot of sattva, you will radiate also the cheerfulness to the other. So where is sattva sattvic food? Where is sattva is available? You can get fruits, very good. Vegetables, fruits, green vegetables and sprouts. Pulses, all this you will get sattva. So if you check your food and then you can increase the sattva. And you require tamasic food also to some extent so that you can see. And you require rajasic food for pull the action, activity. Okay? Then, we increased already our sattva by doing the yoga. Now, technology of the spirituality. What is meant by this? See, what is meant by success in the life? Not having a lot of money, not having a lot of fame. Popularity and many people are listening to you. That is also will not give you the, that is not the success. What is success mean? A smile. Whatever the adverse conditions also to the neighbor to smile, that is meant by real success. So, what is spirituality according to Sri Sri Ravishankarji? Can we put like this? Getting excellent but not getting stressed out or getting tired of doing it. So, that is the technology of the spirit. Now, what is meant by stress? So what is that stopping us from smiling? The stress automatically. So how we get stress? When you don't accept a person or a situation, sometimes the color, sometimes different colors also give you the stress. Then, so this adverse, you expect something, it won't happen, then also you get the stress. So how to combat the stress? How to eliminate stress from our body? By breath. So, breath through the breath. Yes, there are many methods maybe. But breath is very, very powerful. So about the breath, my colleague Manjiri is going to come. And also when you take the breath in the right way, you will feel better. You look better and you give breath.
faster. We ranting at whoever's in front of us, right? Our body becomes hot, our breath becomes very fast. Have you observed that? Yes. Okay. Now imagine you're going to a jungle and you see a lion. When you see a lion, what will happen to you? Suddenly you go, yeah, you get scared, body becomes cold, your breath stops. Isn't that true?
Sometimes you feel that so.
Sometimes you
shivering.
Yeah, you start feeling cold, you start shivering, sweating, yes? All that happens when you're scared, right? What will be your next step? You can't think very clearly. Okay. Great. Now if I have a flower and I give you a nice flower to smell, right? It's a lovely smell, divine almost. So when we smell that flower, how's our breath? Peaceful? Pleasant. Okay. What else?
Deep.
Deep, slow and gentle, right?
Soothing.
And a soothing kind of a thing. Okay. So, what you have just...
When we are silent and upset?
How is our breath? Did you notice our breath that time? Very shallow and you're not breathing correctly at those times, right?
You're burdened with the stress and you're breathing.
So, what we have just seen is, depending on our emotions, depends the rhythm or the pattern of our breathing, right? So, if that is true, if the breath is linked to the emotions, then the reverse should also be true. If by controlling our breath, we will be able to control our emotions. Isn't that right? Now, very often we have told ourselves, come what may, I will not get angry today. I will be calm, I will be quiet. But as soon as your little daughter or your child comes and he does something naughty, you shout at that child. You know, he might be just a baby doing something, needn't have shouted so much at him. But you can't help yourself, or you shout at your wife or your husband, you know, and you cannot control yourself. So to control the mind, at the level of the mind, by the mind itself is very, very key. But there is one way of controlling the mind, and that is through the breath. The breath is a very, very important function because it links our mind, our external body with the spirit inside. Another thing about breath is that without breath, we cannot even survive for 2 or 3 minutes. But if I were to ask you, don't eat for 2-3 days, don't have any water, maybe you will be able to. But if I ask you, stop breathing for 2-3 minutes, beyond that, you will not be able to survive without your breath. That is how important the breath is. And yet, we pay very little attention to our breath. Okay? What happens with the breath is, it connects our inner world of silence. We all are experiencing peace and calm sometimes, right? That inner world of silence and the external activity is connected through the breath. Every time we breathe in, the breath nourishes our body. Without even realizing it, it's happening all the time, okay? And whenever you breathe out, it relaxes your body. For example, if I were to lift a very heavy chair, what would be my reaction? It would be like, oh! Like this, my breath will be also harder and I'll lift the chair up. And then I come home after a day's hard work, I'm really tired, I go to the fridge, have a nice cold glass of water and I feel, yeah, you feel relaxed. So can you see, when you do, you're relaxing your body. And when you're breathing in, you're taking in all the nourishment, all the energy. So that is how important breath is. Another very important function about the breath is, 85% of our toxins are released through the breath. You all know of carbon dioxide and any other gases which are harmful to your body is all released through the breath. So 85% of our toxins are released through the breath. Unfortunately, we use only 35% of our lung capacity. If we were able to use more of our lung capacity, we would be able to throw out more toxins. And if we throw out more toxins, we will be healthier and happier, right? So, we only use 35% of our lung capacity. Now, when we came into the world, what did we do? We cried, and with that we took a breath in, right? And when we will die, we are going to let go of our breath, or we are going to breathe out. So, in between this breath in and breath out is all what life is. The lifespan is just nothing but something between breathing in and breathing out. Okay. So, in better and have a healthier state of mind. Okay. So now to tell you more about the nature of the mind, I'll give it to Shankar.
Yeah.
exposing ourselves to the stress. Unnecessary stress by keeping ourselves either in the past or in the future. So what we have to do? We have to bring our mind to the present. Okay? So which will help you to bring the mind into the present? Right? So you want to, when you are retaining the breath, then you automatically your mind will come. Because then the link is there already. When the mind and the breath, then the link is already there. So you are attending to the breath, the mind will come to be present and you will be, you are, the whole health will be restored once again. The calm means peace of mind, everything will be restored. Okay? And the nature of the mind is also not only living in the past or the future, but the mind will be. Suppose if I give you 10 compliments and one negative statement, then the mind is having a tendency to get stuck at the negative. If I tell that you are smiling very nicely, you are looking very wise, and you are on time, punctual, and you have done, always your dress sense is very good. So like this, I'll give you some 10 compliments. And one negative statement, something if I give you. All time you will forget, and we will remember this one negative and put it in our pocket or in our bag and carry it made about it. That is the tendency. And also, the mind is always either it wants to agree or disagree. So, when I am talking about the four sources of energy or different layers of our consciousness, either yes, yes, it is true, it is true, or no, it is not true. This is also the tendency of the. So, what we have to do, we have to reverse this procedure of the mind telling something to us instead of difficult. Yeah? You want to know? There is one technique, breathing technique. This is called Bhastrika. So, Bhastrika Pranayama. Pranayama means already you know it is second life force energy. So, how this Ayama means Yama or Ayama? It will be how you will directing or controlling your prana to different parts of your body. So pranayama, bhastrika. So how we will do? Generally it is ideal if we sit down in the vajrasana, one type of asana, and do it. But we are sitting on the chair, so we will sit on the chairs and continue to do this. Loose fist in front of the shoulders. Manjiri will demonstrate to us.
So you are giving a lot of prana to your system. So you will relax and you will
observe all the sensations in the body. Then again, for the second round, same thing. Position. And again, you will do 20. Again, 1. Now, this is 1. Like this, 20. So, 20, relax. 20, relax. And 20, relax. So, 20, 20.
60.
Yeah, 60 or not with one go. You have to relax. Okay? So, you will get a lot of relaxation. Okay? So, close your eyes. You are all doing very well. So, I don't have to. If there is anything you feel that you are not doing well or you want to check once, you just open your eyes and check. Okay? And close your eyes once. Eyes closed. First, empty the lungs. Take a deep breath in. And breathe out. Wait. Once again, take a deep breath in. And breathe out. I'll tell you first Sita. That time only when. Hands down. Now we will do it together. Bastrika. In, out. 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 And relax. Palms on the knees, facing the ceiling. Keep the eyes closed. Observe the sensations in your body. Completely. is Vastrika. In, out. 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 And relax. Palms on the knees, facing the ceiling.
Yeah.
are like the blocks. Down and
thank you.
panchakosha meditation which we have done this morning is called as panchakosha meditation. So we have so many things in our completing course. The main is so it is like in a small test before you take the appetizer, like this day, the whole meal is there in our completing course. So the main highlight of our course is Sudarshan Kriya. So mean proper, Darshan mean healing, Kriya mean beautiful intention. So in Sudarshan Kriya, whole of our healing will be cleansed with the rhythmic breaths. So what does this course does? It helps you reducing stress, tension, it translates into healthier life, improve focus, concentration, translate to be a more harmonious person and a more successful professional. Yeah. And also, you want to rest at the same time alert. Suppose if you are sleeping, you are taking rest, but are you alert? No. But when you are doing the Sudarshana Kriya or the meditation, then what will happen? You are alert. But we are rest. So restful awareness, restful alertness, which is very, very difficult to get. But when you are doing Sudarshana Kriya, then you will get it easy. So this about this one, I already said. This is a rhythmic breathing technique. Eliminates all your stress, fatigue, negative emotions, which are body stress, anger, frustration, depression, etc. And when all the negatives will go away, what will be left? Yourself. And the last, the seven layers, the last one is what? The self. So you will be that. So energized and you will focus better and concentration levels will increase, confidence levels will increase. And how the Sudarshana Kriya and Pranayama, SK means Sudarshana Kriya Pranayama, will help us. R&D Institute of Medical Sciences and NIMHANS, these two they have done different research about the Sudarshana Kriya. Where is R&D Institute of Medical Sciences? In Delhi. So they have done this one. And what they found is, there is a these are too many medical terms, so we will not go into that one too much. But what you can say is, bad cholesterol levels will be at the minimum, good cholesterol levels will be at the maximum. And also it will give you the anti-aging and the aging. So, see when you are taking Sudarshana Kriya, every cell of your body will get oxygen. So then, automatically the oxygen is going to every cell, so therefore the anti-aging effect will be there. Then also we have seen the school children, the ones who are not addicted to the smoking, the research says that one, they will be able to come out of that. And it is, see the last one, fast, effective and no side effects. So if you drink alcohol, one drinks alcohol or smoking, then they take the next stimulant. But here, in Art of Living or Sudarshana Kriya, it stimulates you not, but without any side effects. And it is possible. And also, this, as I told you, the relaxed alertness you will get, the easy, you can go to this. The first one is a control group, second one is the next one. The ones who are doing this version. And also it says better immune status, antioxidant effects, freedom from addiction. I already covered healthier body and healthier. So how long is this course? There are two formats. One is 3-day course, 3.5 hours to 4 hours. Another format is 6 days, which is each day 3 hours. So any the ones who are not having much time, for them the 3 days. And let us do it relaxing. Let us go through the whole knowledge points which we are going to give you in the in our course, especially everything. breathing. Let us go through this one, yoga and all, relaxing breathing. But then it is the six papers. Yeah? And let me tell you one. Suppose you do not know how to paint and lot of colors are given to you. One paper is given to you to paint. What will you do? Mess. Yes or no? Suppose if you know how to color nicely, you will make a nice paper, painting and you take it with a lot of beauty. Yes? It's the same thing. When you have the mobile phone, if you got the mobile phone, you got the manual. Yeah? When you bought your washing machine, you got a manual. TV, manual. Yeah? You got it. When you got the life, you got any manual? How to read it? The mind will throw you towards the anger, mind will throw you towards some frustration. You do not know how to handle this mind. There is no manual is given. Right? And in the schools, is it taught? Anywhere, how to handle your mind? Anywhere it is taught? There is so many other academics. But how to handle the mind? Is it taught? Except this is one thing. The manual will be given to you in Antapurin course. How to handle it? This one is like in Antapurin course, it is a you will go, everything you go to the experience. Like, I am telling you, be in the present moment. So how can you be? That is what exactly experience. In the books and also, how many books are there in the libraries? You can read about each other. But after the course, you will experience whatever it is said in the books. Yeah? Whatever we are telling you, it is at the experiential level. Yeah? And all those who want to do something creative every day, this is what the those who want to create every day, those who want to spread peace, love and the question, whether this course will benefit me? Millions of people have done. Other many people have done millions of people. So definitely as I say, I have taken the courses for the last 4 years. I say each time they will come with the stress and frustration. I see the going, it is fine. And they told me that they better. One of my students came with a small face to the course on the first day, that is 6 days. Then I asked him a question, why you are so udasin now? And then he said, we are looking, you are not so interested, different from the remaining people. No, she is not talking to the remaining. And on the second day, third day, she started working. Her husband worked in the single bomb class in the railway, and the rest of the thing happened 6 or 5 years back. So then she was left alone with the 3 kids, 2 kids. And then, the life has pushed towards this type of rolling this world. But she's not knowing that how to handle it. So, 4, 6 days, four, she's over. Confidence. Yeah, my children are not having, they lost the one parent, but as if I was there also, it is as if there is no parent for them, one parent also. Now they got at least one parent. Now I can do not present. I got that confidence. And now later I met her many times, it was very exciting. She can handle it over. The past was over. The husband died. Now one has to forget it. That one has to forget that thing. We know it by a concept. But then the Sudarshan Kriya and remaining all our processes, then he will do it and he will practice it. Okay? Any of your experience you want to share?
Sudarshan Kriya is a series of pranayams which are put together. And it takes hardly about 15-20 minutes to do every day. Once you learn it, it will be taught to you in the art of doing part one course. So once you do it, it hardly takes about 15-20 minutes to do at home. And I find having practiced this question here regularly, earlier if somebody said something to me, I used to get hurt a lot. Okay? And you would be upset for maybe 5-6 hours because somebody said something to you. And that person is gone away also. You don't, he doesn't remember, it's not bothering him. But because he said something to you, it's bothering you, right? But now after doing the Sudarshan Kriya, same thing with anger, same thing with any other worry or tension you might have, you find you are able to face things better by just doing your breathing regularly. Because as we talked earlier, the breath can control our mind. So when in a Sudarshan Kriya, you are taught rhythmic breathing, and that helps you take care or tackle your mind better. So it's a wonderful course, you will enjoy it, and it's great fun.
And also, I used to have a migraine. Weekly, I used to get twice, and each time when it comes, I usually choose to stay for 3 days. That means all the time I used to suffer with migraine, which I got it after my first childbirth. So for 15 years I suffered with the migraine. So after that I went to the other course within 2 months. From practicing this one regularly, I got it. And suddenly after 2 months, my family asked me, if you are not eating this migraine medicine, then I realized, yeah, it has gone. Like that, the medicine can be there. That is there, no, gone. Like that, really, gone. Which I suffered for 15 years. Like this, I see people, sciatica nerve disorder, they got very much relaxed, relaxation from this problem. And diabetic people control. I see people, my sister, her diabetic, if she does that one for 1 month continuously, diabetic, that number will come down. Otherwise, the sugar levels will increase. So she is doing, you know, sometimes she will not do it, she will practice it, some problem is that she won't practice. Sometimes we can see that the sugar levels are going up. And then BP levels also will come down. And you will manage many things, more than that, what you need to be. And you do not have to give much time for this, just 25 minutes later. Something will add to your lifestyle, you don't have to change your lifestyle. Same thing, it continue, but something will be added to this. Just for 25 minutes, anyway, you don't have to. Have you done yoga earlier? Are you doing every day? For that, you have to go somewhere and do it. But this one, at home, you know, just anywhere, in a small corner also, you can just get your work. Or the asana, and you can sit down and it is just for 25 minutes. And if you do the meditation for 20 minutes, see, after Sudarshan Kriya, you do the meditation, you will go very deep. And even in the Sudarshan, after Sudarshan Kriya, also you will be of the meditation. So once you do the meditation for 20 minutes, after that one will give you the rest, which is equivalent to something like 2 to 4 hours. So, suppose if you take 2 hours also, 20 minutes you are spending listening on three Sudarshan Kriya, and you are getting still 1.5 hours time. So, your number of hours are increased. And also, you will save your time by being in the present moment also. We are wasting lot of our time getting stuck in the past or in the future. That way also, when you are alert, and you are in the present moment also, you will save your time. About our organization. Last 30 years we are working for the sake of the people. And especially the research that we did is stress-free mind and violence-free society. We require quite a lot. Today the interview was there in the news in our TV just before coming, I have seen. The interviewer about that rape case of the Nirshaya, and the parents were being interviewed. What is the last thing you wanted to see after the Vanatapada and Shashi? So the parent asked the father, Maya's father, last sentence is, either or either he is speaking in either way, either way, and ask the newspaper. What is the cause of this one? That is what he. So what is the cause? Right? Not like the human values, not we are teaching in our schools or anything. So the human values are. So exactly.